kisiwa hichi nilikuwa nakijua nilipokuwa mdogo. Na hali ya samaki walikuwa wengi. Lakini sasa hivi mafuriko yanatishia amani.
The pressure of the salt water is coming in the villages. That's mangrove. After maybe 20, 25 years, Zanzibar will disappear. North Zanzibar.
Natumaini mambo yatabadilika.
I'm Zanzibarian, and I'm living in these small islands in Zanzibar. And I personally experience the impacts of the climate change to my localities. Damage of the houses, damage of the infrastructure, displacement of the people from one place to another, brackish drinking water. Because of the impact of the climate change, that is saltwater intrusion, this is happening now. When we have mangroves along the coastal area, they are used to protect the earth from coastal erosion.
Mangrove is necessary for fish because the small fish live in the upper root of mangroves.
Mangroves play an essential role to the society by absorbing large amount of the carbon dioxide. Mangroves has ability to absorb about 3 to 4 times the carbon dioxide over the other forests. Climate change impacts the survival of this mangrove. Anthropogenic influences severely impact the mangroves and the ecosystem. They are cutting down these mangroves because of their man-made activities. They prefer firewood material from those mangroves. They were not aware of the advantages of mangroves, and also they were not aware of the impact of the climate change. What are the proper measures to be taken so as to combat these impacts?
The YouthMappers are student-led chapters around the world, and they help in creating and utilizing open data.
With the open data, they help in portraying what is happening in the community and what people are facing across the world.
What they do is they create maps and they create mappers.
They make sure that they extract the data from the community because the community, they have more knowledge on their environments.
I will use this to take the area that is affected with climate change, like coastal area, and to visualize to my society to see this is real effect.
But in addition to that, they also give them education on climate change. The students build their capacities and they learn new tools, new technologies that are available. And from there, they help in creating open data, and open data is used by the government and by other different stakeholders to make informed decisions.
Digital Earth Africa is a platform that offers ready-made satellite data. As a geo-informer, I have skills of Earth observation data on how to use geospatial tools to solve the problem that the Earth is facing today. Through these technologies such as Earth observation data, we can have information that show the Earth now and before.
We can use spatial data in mangroves to see if the mangroves have been destroyed in past few years, or the mangroves have been grown, or any change that has been taking place in a certain area. Because we can combine that data in a real map, and then we can use it to get different ideas and decisions.
They can understand from those images as this is the place where people go and cut the trees.
Through Digital Earth Africa, people are sharing their knowledge. The guys who made that platform, Dr. Ken, he's willing to help everyone to understand what they are doing there, to share, to do.
The big data that is availed through the various platforms like Digital Earth Africa running on the AWS, these are the game changers. The information on the Digital Earth Africa platform helps State University of Zanzibar lecturers and YouthMappers to actually be able to get more information about the trends which is available from the analysis ready data. Looking at some of the products we've developed with Kyria and students, the one for mangrove changes. So they actually see a rise in mangroves in this area, or maybe there was a loss of mangroves in certain areas. So they can actually see the areas that they need to prioritize and also help us to invalidate in what they get from the platform for us to improve our processing. As the image in the Digital Earth Africa spans over 30 years plus, they've been able to get time series analysis of the mangroves and see some of the areas, how the trends have been. Initially, they started with the Landsat data at 30 meters, and now they're using Sentinel-2 at 10 meters. They're able to get much, much, much information. At Digital Earth Africa, we are dealing with petabytes of information. It has to be on a web service where we can actually update it as much as possible. We are looking also going beyond 5 petabytes for the continent.
Land cover changes. We can observe climate variability to model maybe the floods, to model the coastal erosion. So as if you want maybe to add some features to that model, you can do that in Digital Earth Africa.
We are working with Raya, who's been able to mentor the students. Kyria has been able to showcase the value for mangroves assessment using the Digital Earth Africa platform. The value also of citizen-generated science and the champions is coming out very strongly.
I have already gained the knowledge about climate change, and I will use that knowledge to instruct others, to teach others, to engage with the groups that perform the activities to reduce the climate change. And as you know, everywhere now the climate change is the issues. So I hope that this will be reduced, but the technology is required for it.
The champions, they're actually the driving force of some of the needs and priorities of our products. So once we engage with the champions, they'll tell us what they want to see. They want more data, high resolution. We listen to them. This gives us a motivation to see what other products and data we could actually add from our side to deliver the service to everyone in the continent.
And I hope through these technologies, they can help us to provide awareness to the communities on what is the role of the mangroves to the society. So now they are realizing that, oh, we are not supposed to cut this tree, and instead we have to plant this tree as much as possible.
Some of the YouthMappers students are also volunteering at Zaveco, and one of the projects that they do is to plant more mangroves, so they preserve the areas with their mangroves. And they try to make sure that they plant more and more.
Just cutting maybe one, planting 25. Or cutting two, just planting 1,000. We have more than 200 people now planting every Saturday. And we have planned that when we arrive here, 1,000 seeds, our nursery, in one day.
At State University of Zanzibar, they are training their students, so the students will be the champions, and one day in the future this student might be the president of Tanzania or somewhere. So they'll be able to use this to make very good informed decisions. in Africa which says that alone you can move faster. However, as a village, we can actually move further.
We join hands and we join our forces in making sure we combat these climate change issues.